Arch Oboler's Lights Out, Everybody. It is later than you think.
This is Arch Oboler bringing you another in our series of stories of the unusual. And once again, we caution you, these lights-out stories are definitely not for the timid soul. So we tell you calmly and very sincerely, if you frighten easily, turn off your radio now. What you're going to hear now is pure radio, not a play for a pictureless TV. It's radio about two people, one of whom may be you, in Mirage.
Linda?
Yes,
sir. I've been looking for you.
Lie for you.
Now, look, Linda, this party, it's getting a little too much for me. It's a great night. How about a little walk on the beach?
All right. But quickly, before someone changes my mind.
Get your rest?
No. No, I'll let the moonlight keep me warm.
That air's good.
Careful. Night air.
You know, I never could understand the hunters. They build this place here on the shore, and then when they give a party, they seal the windows hermetically. Here, down this path.
Yes.
Boy, that breeze off the sea is good. Don't you think so?
Frankly, Carl, I didn't come out here for the air. I've been very anxious to talk to you. Very.
That's flattering.
Won't be when you hear why I want to talk to you. Carl, I've always liked you.
And are you?
Liking you, I've tried to understand you as you are, but must you be so antisocial?
Antisocial, me?
The Rensselaers had a dinner party last night.
Oh, that. The office. I couldn't break away.
The Carters were expecting you the night before last at the theater.
Linda, I'm a businessman.
Carl, you can't disappoint people continually and expect them to have any regard for you.
My friends know I'm a busy man.
You and I belong to a set that demands certain social obligations from us.
I wonder if you know how pompous that sounds.
Pompous or not, it's the truth. Oh, Carl, you can't just ignore social obligations.
I'm here, am I not? Ocean's rather calm, isn't it?
They were talking about you only last week at the Pages.
Pages? Say, J.B. made a good thing out of International Motors last week. Must have cleaned up a quarter of a million.
Someone mentioned your name, and this other person laughed and said, don't invite him unless you let him bring his stock ticker.
Idea, Matt.
I hear the same about you wherever I go, Carl. There isn't a man I know who spends as much time at work as you do.
That's what I want. Why shouldn't I?
Now, Carl, understand me. I appreciate the importance of money. But after all, you could find time for your friends. Why do you laugh?
I just remembered why I wanted to be alone with you.
Well?
I was going to lecture you.
What?
Lecture. Really, I was. I was going to tell you that you've been burning the social candle at both ends, or words to that effect.
Really?
You are, you know. Bazaars and style shows and all that nonsense. But you took the offensive, so I forgot what I wanted to say. And that reminds me...
You're remembering a great number of things, aren't you?
Yep. One of the things was to tell you that you're looking very lovely tonight.
The man's human.
You're irritated with me, aren't you?
I am. Oh, Carl, you could be an utterly charming man if you'd forget your stocks and bonds and debentures and all the rest of that for a while and start enjoying...
Linda, now you've got me irritated. Just because my idea of living doesn't include a room full of jabbering idiots...
I think we'd better go back.
Now, wait a minute, Linda. Oh, Linda. Let's call a truce on this. After all, we're a couple of mature people. Let's act maturely and leave each other alone and enjoy the night. How about it?
Oh, you're hopeless. But, all right.
Good. We'll get off on safe subjects. The sea, the weather, the moon, June, the number of days to Christmas.
Exactly.
We'll start with the sea. Calm, isn't it?
You walk so fast, Carl, please.
No. I forgot. The sand must be ruining your slippers.
No. Beach is packed so hard, I'm quite all right. Just don't walk too fast.
Right. Fine place the hunters have here.
They do have successful parties.
Yeah. Hunter bought this place right before 29. Understand, he tried to unload it all through the Depression, but couldn't get even enough to cover the land value.
Did you hear about Ivy's debut?
Hmm?
Margaret naturally wanted to have it at the Claremont, but Tom insisted on their country place.
Well, that's understandable. Poor Tom dropped enough in that amalgamated merger to make him re-entrench all the way around.
Oh?
Amazing. Man of his experience not knowing that you can't disturb the capital investment of an organization without jeopardizing...
Now, just a minute, Mr. Laughlin. If you're thinking of starting on capital investments again, I'd better remind you that this conversation is limited to, remember? June, moon.
What moon?
Well, of all the inconsiderate clouds I ever... Carl, what are you staring at?
I can't quite make out. Do you see anything down there? Near the water's edge?
Why, yes, there is something there.
It's so dark.
Carl, it moved.
I saw.
Is it a dog?
I'm not sure.
Let's go closer.
No, Linda, wait. Linda, come back.
Carl, come quickly.
What is it?
Look, it's someone sitting on the sand.
Well, who in the world?
Oh, a drunk. Just someone who's lost his way to the bar. Come on.
Linda, wait.
No, wait for what?
I better see who it is and give him a hand.
All right. If you must play the Good Samaritan, go ahead.
I say there, fella.
What else the drunken fool doing? Digging for clams?
I have to get closer. I say there, old boy. Trying to get a little wet there when the tide comes in, aren't you?
Well, drunk and dumb.
I guess you're right.
Oh, let's go on.
No, wait, please.
Why?
The moon will be out in a minute. I want to see what he's doing. Now we'll see. Why, it's an old man.
Rising in the sand.
What are you doing here?
Guess he just won't talk.
Well, how do you like that? Writing in the sand with the point of his finger.
Carl, I don't like this at all. Come away.
What is it?
Nothing. Nothing at all. If this old man wants to sit here in the dark in the sand, let him. Why does it concern
but
us?
But what's he writing? I can't quite make out. Oh, the moon went under.
Carl, are you staying here?
Well, I'm sorry. I want to see what the man's writing. What are you writing, old man? Old man, don't you hear me talking to you?
Oh, Carl, you're being insufferable.
Linda, where's your curiosity? A deserted beach after midnight, an old man writing heaven knows what in the sand. Aren't you interested in knowing?
I'm not interested in maniacs. Who else but a psychopathic would...
Linda, wait. Wait, the moon's coming through the clouds again. Now we'll see. You see it too? He's writing names in the sand. Names of people.
Carl.
What is it, Linda?
His face.
What'd you say?
Face. Did you see his face?
No, I didn't see it. Linda, what's the matter?
Face.
What about his face? There's all these blasted clouds I can't see. There. Light again. There's nothing wrong with his face.
I thought...
Just an old man. Must be a gardener. Writing names in the sand.
I want to know who he is.
Well, now you're curious.
I want to know who he is, Carl.
And I'm certainly going to find out. Old man, we insist on knowing who you are. Do you hear me, old man? We insist. No attention. Must be deaf.
Clouds covering the moon. Sea so green. Even in the night. Carl, I'm cold. Let's go in.
If that isn't like a woman. One minute you're curious and the next minute you're cold. Ah. Moon's bright now. Look. Look. You can see some of the names he's writing. John Barclay. March 2nd, 1939. Well, that's today. Well, how do you like that? He wiped the name out, and he's writing another one.
James Ellison, March 2nd, 1939.
Wiped that out. Writing another one.
Name after name.
But why? Old man, can you hear me? Why?
What would he say?
He's certainly not drunk. Eyes so bright, so intent on his work. And what work?
Carl, don't laugh.
What did you say?
He seems so busy.
Linda, what is there about this old man that disturbs you? I think he's funny.
Carl.
A dirty little unshaven old man crouched over writing names in the sand with the point of his finger. That's a serious career, isn't
Carl,
it?
No.
A career for one's old age. No overhead, no competition, no profit. Sit in the open air and write in the sands of time. Linda, I tell you, when I get too old for Wall Street, I think I'll join this old
Carl.
Man. And... Huh?
Look. Your name. He's writing your name.
Well, what do you know about...
C.A.
The old fraud can hear.
Ah.
Must have overheard you say my name.
Carl. Your last name. He's writing that, too.
But that's impossible. He doesn't know.
He is writing it. L. A.
He.
U.
He doesn't know.
G.
Why?
How slowly he forms each letter.
How does he know? Why does he write?
Carl, what is it?
I don't know. I feel sick.
Carl.
Don't let me fall.
Oh, man, help me.
He's...
Help me.
My name.
No.
I can't breathe.
Carl, I can't
wake you up.
Oh, help me. Someone help me breathe. Standing up again.
I feel all right.
What happened? Why did you frighten me so?
My name. In the sand. Where?
The surf. He came in and wiped it out before he finished.
Old man, why did you write my name? How'd you know who I was? Answer me, why did you write my name?
What difference does that make, Carl? You're ill. Let's get back to the house.
No, I feel fine. Sudden dizziness, but I'm all right. I want to know how and why this old...
He's writing again.
L-I-N. Your name.
Yes.
D-A.
Carl, take me home.
Wait, he can't possibly know your last name. J-E-F. He does know it.
Carl, please, I don't...
F-E-R. Writing so slowly, as if he wasn't quite sure. But he does know it. Linda, how in the world do you imagine he knows... Linda.
Carl. Help me.
Linda, what is it?
Hold me.
Yes. Yes, I'm holding you. Linda, in heaven's name, what is it?
My heart. Falling.
Linda.
Falling.
Linda.
Falling.
Linda!
Carl.
What?
Carl. Why are you holding me in your arms?
You were ill. Fainting.
What are you talking about?
Are you joking?
What is there to joke about? Carl, please let go of me.
All right.
Oh, yes, my name. He was writing my name.
Yes.
Where is it? Sam, he's writing another name. Where's mine?
That wave. Must have washed it out before he finished.
I remember now. My heart. I couldn't see. Darkness. I was falling.
Yes. Falling.
Your face so white. Carl, why?
As he wrote my name, I felt as if I were dying.
No.
And then you. You felt that way, too, as you wrote your name, didn't you?
Yes. Yes, I did.
How cold it is here.
How cold?
Still writing.
Oh, no.
The moon. Gone.
Stay by me.
Yes.
Still where?
Darker than the darkness.
I can't stand it anymore. Oh, man, who are you?
Linda, stay away from him. Don't. Linda. Linda. What is it?
No one.
What?
No one. Here.
But he was here. I saw him.
Carl, find him. Find him and talk to him. I've got to know. I've got to know.
Old man. Where are you? Old man.
There he is there. Far down the beach.
We've got to catch him. Come. Old man. Wait. Old man.
Old man, wait. Wait, I beg you.
Old man, wait. I want to talk to you. No one.
I thought.
There he is.
Where?
The other way, at the edge of the water. Old man! Wait, old man!
Wait for me, Carl. Wait. Please, wait. Carl. Why did you stop?
No one. I thought I saw. But there's no one.
Oh, no.
If only the moon came out again.
Find him for me, Carl. Find him for me.
You blasted moon, get out. Come out.
Oh, man.
Linda.
What?
Linda.
You laughing?
Yes, of course I'm laughing. What we just heard, the wind, our friends back at the house.
Friends?
Yes, friends. That wind and the sound of them talking, it cleared my head. I must have been out of my head all this time. And you too, Linda.
Our friends?
Yes. Yes, our friends. Back there, only a few hundred feet from here. Lights and music and reality.
This hasn't been reality?
Linda, all my life I've been a practical man. My life has been like my business. Everything has had debits and credits. This that's been happening to us. My head's clear now. I can think of it in practical terms.
Tell me.
We met an old man writing in the sand.
He wrote my name.
And mine, too. All that was real enough. Now then, how did he know our name?
Yes.
Simple enough. You and I are not unknown. He must have been an old gardener on the estate here. Yes, that's it. He heard of us and then heard us call each other by our given names. And so he knew the rest of it.
But when he wrote our names, we...
Yes, 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 I know the dizziness. It's all quite easily explained. Back in the house, the air was bad. We came outside, both of us nerves on edge, too much fresh air. Dizziness followed, and we... Oh, why talk about it anymore? Let's go back to the house.
Yes, Carl. Yes, quickly.
Now, careful, not so fast you'll fall.
I'm all right. Faster, Carl. I want to get back.
A drink, that's what I need. A drink of two or three, a dozen.
So very dark.
Infernal clouds. Let's stay along the water's edge. Easier to walk.
Yes.
Fantasy in the night, that's all it was. We let our imaginations run away with us. Imagine things that didn't exist.
Carl.
Why do you stop?
Carl.
Why are you pointing?
He's writing again.
He's there, writing again.
Old man. Old man!
Carl, don't leave me. Oh, God, it's so dark. Carl!
Gone again. Gone again.
Take me back to the house, quickly. Oh, quickly, don't stand there. We'll run.
Wait. The moon. Shining down so strangely. Everything's so strange.
So strange?
Yes.
Carl, at the edge of the water.
What?
Our names.
Our
names. Our names in the sand. See them.
Yes.
There's a date written after my name.
And after mine.
I can't see the date. What?
A wave. It's coming. Linda, come back.
No, I've got to
Linda.
See.
Linda! I did, too.
The date when I... Oh, no.
No. No, it isn't true. It isn't. A date written in the sand, it doesn't mean anything. It doesn't. Does it, Linda?
I didn't think it would be so soon.
You believe?
Yes.
I do too, somehow.
But so soon.
No. No, I won't believe. I won't. I'm going to live a long time, 50, 60 more years. My family, they lived long lives. My father, my grandfather, this can't be true.
Carl, don't be so afraid.
You're not.
I am. And yet, somehow it's wonderful.
Wonderful?
Yes. Wonderful. What every person in the world wants to know. We know. You and I.
It'll be spring that year when I...
No. No, don't think of it that way. The wonder of it, Carl. Think of that.
I never thought much about the wonder of things.
Oh, how good the air is. Like wine. I've heard them call it that. I never believed a breath could be so wonderful.
If a man planned every minute that was left, how much he could do...
That's why I say it's wonderful, Carl. I know what I have left. I can plan the days, the hours... Live each one because I know just how many of them I have. Carl. Oh, Carl. I'm almost happy now.
Happy?
Yes. Yes, why not? Now I'll do the things I wanted to do. Yes. Every one. Listen to them back there, Carl. I never really wanted that.
But you always...
Because that was the path my mother had gone. The one she led me to. But all the time, the snobbery of money. Those silly little family destinies. I wasn't happy. Because it wasn't what I really wanted. I knew that. But I went on because... Because always there was a tomorrow. I said to myself, tomorrow, some new tomorrow, I'll start the life I want. I didn't know. But now I know my tomorrow's Carl. I've got to start now. And so I will. And so I'm happy.
What?
A child, Carl. Yes. I want a child. There. I've said what I never thought to say. How I used to laugh at people with their children. Such clever, brittle things. And all the time my heart was in my eyes. A child. Look up. Stars are singing.
they know I'm free. For a little while, I'm free. And you, Carl? What will you do?
I? What will I do?
Yes. What will you do tomorrow morning?
I? Tomorrow morning, I'll go back to my business, of course. My business. No. No.
Carl, you're holding me.
Yes, Linda. Linda, you and I, we've got to be together.
Oh, Carl.
You're right, there can be happiness in it. For these days and months were free. I have never been free, have I? The cage of my business, money. I am free now. Yes, I am. Travel, Linda, you and I. The world. We'll climb up to these singing stars of yours. When I was a boy, I always thought I'd do that. Travel. Travel. Free. This little world, all of it, mine to know and have. I thought there was plenty of time to start. Tomorrow, there'd always be a tomorrow for me. Yes, I was immortal. I thought that, really. Most of us do, don't we? Everybody else in the world would live their lives and die, but I, always inside of me, I thought I'd live forever, and so I climbed into a cage and stayed there.
Oh, you're holding me so close.
You and I, Linda, together, free until that day. Say it. Say it.
Oh, my dearest. Why did it take death to teach us how to live?
It is later.